I want to show you the jet stream. And normally the jet stream runs right along the U.S.-Canadian border, well to the north in an average summer. So high pressure, normally you have hot temperatures across most of the country. Well, look what's happened this summer. Very, very unusual for us to see this. But there's actually the dip in the jet stream, what we call a trough. It dug all the way down into the eastern part of the country while the heat went out to the west and into parts of the plain states. This is why we're so wet, because we have all this energy with the jet stream in the dip, and it's also a lot of clouds, a lot of rain, and that kept the temperatures down from sort of hot. We actually had warm weather, but also we also had periods of deep tropical moisture across the area this summer, which is very unusual. We're not talking about tropical systems, the remains coming over, but just deep tropical moisture coming out of the Gulf of Mexico. And so that supplied us with all the heavy rain, and when you have deep tropical moisture, we're not going to see a lot of hail because the freezing level remains very high in the atmosphere, so it's hard for those large hailstones to reach the ground. They usually start to melt, and that's the reason we haven't had the severe weather, as Chris was talking about. Also, because of tropical moisture, we end up with a lot of wind shear, so we end up with these thunderstorms that produce brief, weak tornadoes. We've also had that, and also extremely heavy rainfall and the cooler temperatures because of this jet stream. Very, very unusual to see this in the heart of summertime. And the dip in the jet stream has been hanging with us, and it's going to stay with us, it looks like, all the way through the weekend. But some big changes on the way for us as we head toward the end of next week. I'll show you that in the 4-day plus in just a second. Thunderstorms now right along Interstate 77. In fact, they're heading toward the Winston-Salem area. We had some very heavy thunderstorms that rumbled across the area over the upstate this afternoon. Clemson, Anderson, Greenville, Spartanburg. Then they just kind of fizzled out before they made it to you folks in Union, Cherokee, and Blacksburg. And then everything's really quieted down considerably this evening, which is really certainly good news. And we still have the flash flood watch for a certain area, and I'll show you that in just a second. So some rain showers around through the mountains, but notice there's not a lot of reds going on right now, just yellows and greens, so we're only talking about rain showers. The upstate is fairly quiet. We've stabilized the atmosphere a little bit with those thunderstorms rumbling through earlier in the day. Northeastern Georgia also looking pretty decent right now. Flash flood watch still continues for these areas. This is the highest risk for a potential for major flooding because the ground is completely saturated. In fact, it's saturated across the entire viewing area, but this flash flood watch continues until midnight tonight, but there's no heavy rain falling in these areas right now. But rainfall since midnight last night, 0.12 of an inch at the downtown airport in Greenville, almost 0.6 of an inch of rain in Spartanburg, 0.3 in Anderson, and almost 0.6 of an inch of rain at the Asheville Regional Airport. But of course, if you had those really heavy thunderstorms over you, you could have easily had 1 to 2 inches of rain in a short period of time. Hot temperatures outside, humidity levels remaining very high, so it's very steamy outside. It'd be nice to have a little bit of a breeze, but that's certainly not the case. 89 right now in Columbia, also in Augusta, 91 in Florence, currently 90 in Charleston. So there's those thunderstorms that kind of fell apart, and then most of the energy now beginning to head toward the Winston-Salem area. Midlands coastline looking pretty good. More thunderstorms off to our west, but that's not going to affect us until we get into the weekend. So a stationary front obviously means stationary. It's not going anywhere, but it will meander back south and north as we go through the weekend. As you can see, it kind of moves north a little bit. So 6 o'clock tomorrow night, some showers and thunderstorms, the best chance will be in the mountains. Then it moves a little bit farther northwest. Then it starts to slide down slightly. More energy comes in with the afternoon heating on Sunday. That's our best chance of scattered showers and thunderstorms around the area. So scattered showers, maybe a few thunderstorms, about a 40% chance in the upstate and in the mountains. Low 71, a muggy 71, 67 in the mountains. Head into the weekend on Saturday. Scattered mainly afternoon thunderstorms, a 40% chance in the upstate, high near 90, 82 degrees in the mountains, a 50% chance of showers and thunderstorms. 4-day plus looks like this, so we'll keep it hot and muggy over the entire weekend. We gradually lower the temperatures a little bit next week. A good chance of showers and thunderstorms on Tuesday into Tuesday night. Strong cold front comes in. Look at those temperatures on Wednesday, wow. Thursday, and Friday of next week. Almost a touch of fall in the air.
Look, air conditioning will get a break.
If that pans out, how nice will that be?
No kidding,
we deserve it. We really do.
Yes, we do. John, thank you.